Hello, welcome to Istqb foundation level syllabus, and today we are going to discuss about the organizational factor which can make the review successful. So what are the different factors in an organization which can help us to make the review successful in that particular organization? So we will see the role of an organization. Okay, so let's start with our topic with this. So the first factor in an organization that can make the review successful is the clear objective. So the organization has to make objectives very, very clear for everyone, so that the review will be successful at the end. So clear objective means the scope of the review, when the review will start, who all will be the participants, selecting the individuals. So all those things are quite important. And then the second point is review type. So we have already seen this different type of review. So depending upon in an organization and the project and the software which they are developing, they have to see that whether the informal review technique is good for their organization, or the walkthrough, technical review, or an inspection. If your feature is very, very critical, and then if you are going for an informal review, in that way the review will be unsuccessful. So that is what we are talking about. So depending upon the factors, like what type of product you have to select this type of review very carefully. So suppose your software is a very normal type of software and you are selecting an inspection, that means you are involving lots of people, lots of money into it, and that can also result in an unsuccessful review process in an organization. So depending upon the project, you have to select your review types. Similar way, the third point will be the review techniques. So we have seen all these review techniques, like ad hoc review technique, checklist based technique, scenario and dry run based technique, role based technique, and perspective based technique. So these all techniques also has to be selected depending upon the project which we are working on. So if it is a very highly critical project, in that case we have to go for this role based and prospective based, how the user will be thinking of the product and using it. So depending upon that, we have to develop, or we have to understand the product so that we can help in the successful of that particular review process. So this was the third point. And then the checklist. So how good is your checklist to perform the review? So we had a very small checklist. So similar way for your product, what type of checklist you have prepared so that you are not missing any bug and maintaining the quality of that product. So if the quality is maintained, that will be called as a successful review process, and it will help in the success of the organization also. Next is the time and small proportion. So normally review is done after the activity is completed. Okay, so that time review is done. So most of the time we get very less time for this particular activity, review activity. So it is the goal of the organization, or it is should be the decision of the organization, like how much time they are providing so that the review could be effective and the successful. And whether we are performing, when we are performing this particular type of review, in the starting of the software or at the end of the software, when we have a huge amount of code in it. For an example, suppose you have the three component. So it is very difficult to do a review for one component at once. So if someone is giving me this component, then we can find lots of mistake in one component if it is given as a small portion. Similarly, if component B is given after the component A is given, and then C at the end. But if at one shot, if all these components are given A, B, C, and the time is less, in that case what will happen is there is a chance that we will miss some of the bugs. Okay, so this is what how time and proportion is also very, very important, and organization has to provide this in order to make review successful. And the last point in it is support. So organization should support for this review activity throughout the review process. So in that way, we can make the review successful in an organization. So this is it all about the topic, and I will see you in my next video. Until then, happy testing.